want to know the best settings for Counter-Strike 2 and you have similar tech to a 3070 and a Ryzen 9 7950X, well, here they are, with a caveat that my CPU is overclocked. And here are all my settings that you can look at. You can pause real quick if you want. I'll go through them. And all I've done is use AMD Adrenaline software to overclock my CPU. I haven't done anything crazy. So if you have an AMD Adrenaline software or a CPU, all you have to do is go to performance, and tuning. And yours should be on default. If you're not already overclocked, and all you have to do is click overclock. And now, I'm not recommending you do this because you can hurt your computer if you don't have the blessings of the PC gods. So, and all your settings are right and your drivers are updated and all that. So make sure you know what you're doing if you are gonna overclock. And before I switch over there, I am on XMP. So 5600 megahertz for my RAM, 28 and 28. That actually got changed. I prefer enhancing the application settings rather than override. And AMD optimized. I did have an update, so I guess my settings got reset. So good thing I looked at this. Here are the in-game settings for CS2. For best frame rates and graphical performance, you're going to want to make sure you run the game in full screen. Very important. If you keep getting a brightness issue where the setting keeps resetting to 110%, just keep resetting it to 100%, and eventually mine stayed. So there's a little note there. And here are the advanced settings. I have ambient occlusion on medium, and very important, high dynamic range. Gotta have it on quality. The game looks terrible for me on performance, so make sure that you have this on quality. And FSR, another very important setting, you're going to want to make sure that that is disabled. Disabled FSR. Now, this may be different depending on your hardware, especially if you have an AMD graphics card. FSR may be an option you want to mess with. I do have enabled and boost. You know what? That's why. I do have enabled and boost on NVIDIA Reflex low latency. And very importantly, here are the frames. So I am streaming and playing on the same PC, but I'm able to play really smoothly and mostly around 150 to 120 frames per second, with lows around 90 to 95 during heavy gameplay. Render latency hovers around 12 on average, and other than that, those are the settings and those are the frames. So thank you for tuning in. I'll see you in the next one.
thank you for following. You are a god, just like me.